I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to his word.
Jesus demonstrated self-giving love to his ministry as the Good Shepherd. Through his incarnation, Jesus became love, not only through his own sacrifice, but also as God's precious gift to humanity. This season is a time for kindness, thinking of others, and sharing with others. It is a time to love others as God has loved us. As God is love, let us be love also. In the Gospel according to John, we hear, I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. Let us pray. Teach us to love, O God of love, as we prepare for our celebration of the birth of your Son. Fill our hearts with his love, for you, our families, our neighbors, your church, and your world, that all may know your love and the one whom you have sent, Jesus, our Savior. Amen.
The story of Christmas, God becoming human, is filled with the unlikeliest of elements. God chose an unlikely setting for this story, the tiny village of Bethlehem. An unlikely couple as supporting characters in this story, Joseph and Mary. God chose an unlikely audience through which to broadcast the news of Christ's birth, common shepherds. And he chose a newborn infant as the lead character in this life-changing story of redemption, love, and grace, Jesus, the holy child of Bethlehem. Isaiah, the Old Testament prophet, foretold that the Messiah would come and he would be called Emmanuel, God with us. The gospel writer John, having had a personal association with Jesus and looking in retrospect at the miracle of God becoming human, said it this way: "The Word, meaning Jesus, became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. We have beheld his glory, the glory of the only Son of the Heavenly Father." This is the compelling story of Christmas. This is the miraculous story of Bethlehem's child.
Thank you.
we gather to worship Christ, the newborn King, Jesus, the one foretold by prophets hundreds of years before his birth. One of the prominent themes of the Christmas story is that of hope. It was this hope that sustained the chosen people of God, the nation of Israel, as they awaited the promised Messiah. The prophet Isaiah had assured them that their hope would be realized in a child, and that this child would be called Emmanuel, God with us. The hope of the ages resided then, as it does today, in the promised Son of God.
Thank you.
Christmas story. Rulers, kings, and appointed leaders typically arrive from places of prominence with royal announcements and pedigrees. But in the birth of Christ, nothing follows normal protocol. The prophet Micah foretold the tiny village of Bethlehem from which this promised Messiah would come. But until that day arrived, Israel patiently awaited in darkness and despair, longing for an end to the seemingly endless night.
Waiting for Emmanuel.
A young couple from the small village of Nazareth, Joseph and Mary, were engaged to be married when they had an unexpected encounter with God. Angelic visits to each of them individually confirmed the unimaginable. They had been chosen by the Creator of the universe to become the earthly parents to the long-awaited Messiah. Once this child was born, they were to name him Jesus, for he would save his people. Initially overwhelmed at this unexpected news, they willingly accepted the call of God to be his humble servants.
Thank you.
when Mary was nearing the end of her pregnancy, Caesar Augustus issued a decree for a census to be taken of the entire Roman world. Each family was to return to their ancestral home for registration. Joseph, taking Mary, returned to his hometown of Bethlehem, the city of David. Upon arrival, they took up temporary residence in a stable because they'd been unable to find a place to stay. While they were there, Mary gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger. On this night, the Holy Child, Heaven's Child, the Son of God, had come to earth.
Thank you.
was an ordinary night on a Judean hillside just outside of Bethlehem, where there were shepherds keeping watch over their flocks. Shepherds were unlikely candidates for earth-shattering news, but this was a night like none other. Suddenly, the blackness shone with extraordinary light as an angel proclaimed to them the news of Christ's birth. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born. He is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. The skies were instantly filled with a great company of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest and peace on earth." The shepherds immediately went with haste to Bethlehem to see this newborn child.
Baby, see the baby.
Upon arriving at the stable, the shepherds did indeed witness what the angel had told them. A young mother and father, a humble manger stall, and the newborn holy child. All who heard the story of what the shepherds had witnessed were amazed. The young maiden Mary, chosen mother of God, treasured all of this in her heart. As Bethlehem slept, the King of the Ages had come into the very world his tiny hands had once helped create. Earthly parents and shepherds could only marvel at the miracle before them.
Thank you.
The story of Christmas, God becoming human, is filled with the unlikeliest of elements. Only God could conceive such a plan. He chose an unlikely setting for this story, the tiny village of Bethlehem. An unlikely couple as supporting characters in this story, Joseph and Mary. God chose an unlikely audience through which to broadcast the news of Christ's birth, common shepherds. And he chose a newborn infant as the lead character in this life-changing story of redemption, love, and grace, Jesus, the Holy Child of Bethlehem. This is the compelling story of Christmas. This is the miraculous story of Bethlehem's child.
Yeah.
by the power of the Spirit, who sanctify the mother of your Son. Make holy all we offer you this day. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord. Amen. Heavenly Father, who chose the Virgin Mary, full of grace, to be the mother of our Lord and Savior, now fill us with your grace, that we in all things may embrace your will, and with her rejoice in your salvation. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this day and forevermore.
Amen.